Now, what are you working on that you maybe can tell us a little bit about?
So, you know, a lot of different things. So, again, to get the wins, you have to have a good team. And so, you know, South Florida Business Journal, I'm sure you read it.
Absolutely.
There's the book of lists. There was the book of, you know, the top 25 banks, top 25 auto dealers, real estate. Here we are, $11.5 billion industry between Palm Beach and Miami, and we weren't in there, believe it or not. And so by sitting down with a group of stakeholders, we were able to formulate a list, get the participation from our industry, either based on employee or revenue. And now we just finished our third year of that list. And that was a big milestone because that's something that the elected officials read. That's something that a person could be from one of our western cities in the county here, or a legislator could be in Tallahassee, but handling the book of lists, they get that.
Yeah.
And the jobs that are created by that.
Because it is a lot of jobs that are created by the marine industry. I mean, it's more than I think anyone realizes, right?
Well, and again, once the world kind of tipped over in 08, 09, everyone realizes that, you know, higher education's wonderful, but there's a certain trade skill that's being missed, not only in our industry, in construction, in automotive and things, and they pay very good wages. So you think of, you're in Florida, today happens to be a really nice, cool day, but HVAC, big needs, right? Welding, carpentry, you name it, electricians.
Yeah.
So by doing those things, you can advocate on those benefits and using the book of lists to change the schools the way they offer classes.
Very interesting. Because you guys are now doing, we obviously interviewed Sean at the Fort Lauderdale boat about the salty jobs. He's going in and doing these trades that would otherwise really be missed, right?
So it's the same thing. Sitting here today, you know, this won't end up in a written article. This ends up on video. Yeah. And so the CEO of AT&T spoke at a conference I went to a couple years ago, and his business is up 150,000%. And it wasn't because he beat Verizon selling more phones. It was because of video.
Yeah.
And so, again, if you want to learn something, you go on YouTube, right?
Yeah,
and
absolutely.
It'll teach you how to do it. So it was the same thing with this. You think old job fairs, historically, they put out a little table, put a black cloth over it, and put out a squishy ball, a pen set, and say, hey, come work in our industry. Come work for the bank or whatever it may be. Kids today, they all want to work for Google. They want to work for Jeff Bezos at Amazon, whatever it may be. But the reality of it is not everyone will.
Yeah.
We have a great industry. So by doing the video series, it's something that lives. So if they want to show their parents at 8 o'clock at night or 7 a.m. on a Saturday morning, they can sit there and show them on a device, their phone, hey, Mom, Dad, I want to get in this industry. And by the way, it pays 28% higher than the state average.
Whew. Wow. So I had this conversation with my wife the other day. We've